Hello, everybody. Because of his actions this past Monday night on Raw, WWE COO Triple H has declined to participate in this forum until after WrestleMania. So over the next few weeks, we will interview superstars who will participate in the show of shows. My first guest is 14-time world champion John Cena. John, thanks for joining us.
Well, thanks for having me.
I've known you for a long time.
Yeah.
I've had the honor and the privilege to call all of your main event matches, including the past two WrestleManias against The Rock.
Yep.
And I know how those matches affected you, professionally and personally. In fact, you and I talked a lot about it.
Yes.
This past Monday night, I saw something in you that I'd never seen before. Bray Wyatt is affecting you in a way that no other superstar ever has in your history.
In reference to those two matches with The Rock, I wanted to beat The Rock. I felt as if I needed to justify my being, to justify my place in this, in WWE, in the universe. And when I couldn't do that, you start to look at yourself from the outside and you realize, okay, maybe I'm here. And then you get another chance. And then you rise to the occasion. And regardless of maybe I'm here or maybe I'm here, at least you understand my work has meant something. I have been putting in all this time. I have been sacrificing myself. I have been donating my time for something, for purpose. I can give myself solace at the end of the day, sleep fine at night, because I know everything is for the greater good. Everything is going in the right direction. That's where Bray is different, because with Rock, with Dwayne, I even said it on Raw, it was always about being the best. And then you knuckle up and say, no, I'm the best. Well, let's get the two best in the ring and see who the best is. Bray is, maybe it's because he's so new, he doesn't put any of that in perspective. And it's just different, because here I am, having worked day in and day out for 12 years now, trying to build this, with my goal not being, okay, at a certain amount of dollars, I'm done. No, I want to leave the WWE a better place than when I walked in the door at first. That's what I want as my legacy. And a guy like Bray, who doesn't care about rhyme or reason or anything. He doesn't care about who the best is. He sees John Cena and says, I want to turn that guy into a monster.
John, you said Monday night on Raw, quote, I'm afraid of Bray.
Yeah.
Who he is, what he stands for.
Yeah.
He said, you also fear that people may be listening to what he says.
And that's the biggest thing. I've had a lot of competition in my day. I've squared off across that ring with a lot of WWE superstars. But every one of them was focused on defeating me for the purpose of climbing up the ranks. Bray Wyatt, I don't think, even cares about winning. He just wants to destroy everything I've worked my life to build and falsify everything. Not necessarily wins and losses in the WWE, but if he can weaken me to a point to make more people listen to him, and that's the thing, people are listening to him. He has a weird way of holding people's attention. I listen to him, and that's why I said what I said. I had to come to grips with it. Listen, I'm afraid of this, but I even sent out a tweet. I said, fear is an emotion, we all have it. Cowardice is a decision. So be brave enough to face your fears and give it your best shot. I just don't know. He's unscoutable. I don't know what his end game is. And it would be like a tabloid photographer with incriminating photos of a well-respected politician or entertainment official and saying, just at the right time, I'm going to let these go and it's all going to go to hell. I don't know what his plan is, but people are listening to him. And if he's successful at WrestleMania, more people will listen, because in this business, the more momentum you gain, the more impressions you make.
So I want to remind everyone, Friday night on SmackDown, you have a match against Luke Harper of the Wyatt family as you prepare for WrestleMania. Finally, this match with Bray Wyatt at WrestleMania, is it as simple as being about your legacy?
I think it's protecting it. And like I said, my biggest fear is this loose cannon gains enough momentum for people to be hypnotized. I've openly said all the time, you want to buy into my stock, this is what I believe in. You work hard, you show up on time, you stay loyal to those who support you, you respect friends and enemies. That's my stance. By the way, I don't ever give up. Either you're in or you're out. I've never asked you, hey, you need to do this or you need to do that. Bray is trying to shield this idea that is, those are just words, that all my sentiment, all my genuine passion for all this is just false. And when the lights go out, there's a bad Santa back there giving the stone cold middle finger to everybody. That's tough. That's tough to swallow, especially for somebody like me who breaks his neck and comes back in 25% of the recovery time, or destroys his shoulder and comes back in 25% of the recovery time, or has surgery on both elbows and makes sure to come back early because I can't stand being away from the ring. I don't refuse any challenge. I never get frustrated with any situation. But what I fear most is all the sacrifices I've made to try to not win anybody over, but just to try to get people to believe, yes, this is what he stands for. So many times people say, I hate your character, but I totally respect you. That's it. That's my legacy. That's what I want. I don't agree with you, but I respect you. What Bray Wyatt is trying to do is take that respect away. Make me, you know, everybody talks about, well, there's The Rock and then there's Dwayne Johnson. There's just John Cena. And Bray Wyatt is trying to make John Cena some BS character. And the belief and the respect will be gone. So all those opposed will say, I told you so. And all those in favor will just simply say, why? And then I'll be back at square one and have to start all over again. I've been here too long to do that.
John, good luck at WrestleMania. Good luck Friday night at SmackDown, and thanks for joining us.
Thanks, man.